What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Cool Asher here. Welcome back to Arcade Paradise. I am going to do a little something different. I'm gonna give you guys some tips and tricks when you first start and open up the game. It's a really simple game. Everything's self-explanatory. But there's some things that are a little difficult to understand, especially when you play the arcade games, because they are ridiculously hard. Even when you put them on easy settings. But there's a couple things when you first start the game. Obviously, the basics are you are given basically management position of this, King's Wash, your father's washing laundromat place, and because he's on vacation on a yacht somewhere. I forgot where specifically, probably Bahamas. Who the hell knows? But there's like a little mini arcade place in the back that you set up a while back ago with, like, I think you have four arcades. It's the air hockey, race chasers. There's a couple more, like this weird free roam. You're this chick that bakes cakes, and it's like Candy Crusher almost. Something adventure. I have it in the arcade management. Wood Logs Adventure, that's what it's called. Wood Gales, whatever. And there's another one. I forgot what the other one was. But it's not important. You just get those four, and basically, once you figure out that you're making way more money than the washing machine combined, laundromat, whatever you want to call it, the laundromat combined, that you renovate the whole entire back area, which is unfortunate. You don't really get to like choose what you open up first, which would kind of be more fun, in my eyes. There's not a lot of really free play in this. Like, you don't really get to choose specifics. If that makes sense. Especially in placements, and you can't replace arcades, so once you set it there, it's set there, that I know of, but I haven't got that far in the game. But the basics are really pretty simple. When you first start out, the most money you're gonna be making is literally off of trash and literally just the laundromat alone. Don't even worry about the back, because once you progress in the storyline, you'll be making quite more. Trust me, as you can see in the bottom left. You'd be making quite a bit where money's not even an issue anymore. I don't even remember where I'm at specifically. But basically, when you first start out, you're going to be wanting to, once you pick up all the trash, once you get to the area where you can kind of, do what you want to do, literally pick up the trash every day and try to get the max rank off of it. Which will give you 30, I think it's dollars in this game. I don't remember what their currency. I'm pretty sure it's dollars, but it's about 30 bucks every time, especially with S ranks washing machines. Like, when you, in order to even get an S rank when you do a laundry, you have to do it specifically on time. Like, you can't miss a beat. So when it tells you your watch, when it tells you the wash is done, you need to go get it. That's the only way you can get an S rank. Which is about another 30 bucks. You always in the corner up top get little notifications, especially when you're in the free roamish area. But when you first start, you're gonna be want to focus mostly on the washing area, because that's where you're gonna get your money at. Don't even worry about anything else. I always go for these three lines, so three washing machines over here, and the three dryers over here. Because it kind of like they're right next to each other, but there's gonna be some days, especially on the weekends, which are the most popular, obviously. That would make sense. So Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, mostly Friday and Saturday, are your biggest paydays and your biggest days that you'll have a lot of customers. So your popularity will go high. Your popularity means everything in this game. See, obviously, C rank, you get nothing. Here, I'll show you. Like, so Obviously, the trash is behind the over here in this little hobo area. You just press X on it, and so the top red is where you want it. You want it maxed out. The lower, you get like nothing, and it's like a miss. You get $0 for it. Somewhere around like the green is like 10, I think, and the orange is 20. So red maxed out, you get 30 bones. Easy. Every time. It's literally free money is how I see it. If you want to pause the game, you literally press options. Depending on what system you're on, I'm on PS5, so obviously you press the option button, it'll pause the whole entire game. All time will stop, everything will stop. You can always go in here, play this little llama game that literally they stole from Google. It's literally like the T-Rex one. It's a hard-ass game. I can't even beat it. I got to like level like 3 or something like that. And I give up. Yep, I just he just breaks his neck on just jumping for no reason. But pretty simple. Let's see, what else should you know? There will be gum on the sides of things, so definitely keep your eye out for that. If you get it, there are different colors. I think red is 30, blue is 20. And white is like 10 or 5 or something like that. I don't remember. But like, you just literally just, it's a simple mini game. This game is, there it is. See, I think this is like 20 right here. It's not hard to do it. Yep, I was right, it's 20. But I'm telling you, trash is gonna be definitely your biggest. I don't understand how every day you get like trash everywhere, literally when you're the only person here, and I clean it up every day. Like some trash goblin comes every night and just trashes the place. But basically, it's not gonna look like this when you first start, obviously. Oh my god, get out of here. But you're gonna have literally like one game here, two games in the back. This whole wall is gonna be blocked off, and it's not gonna look like this at all. But you're gonna have like this adventure game, you know, stuff like that. There's obviously never enough time to even play the games because you're constantly getting reminded that you need to go do something. Like, this is more of like constant management than actually allowing you to play, you know, any of the games. But I found a little neat trick when if you do want to play the games and get infinite time to play the games, so right when closing time comes around 2300 hours, which is like almost midnight. 2400 is midnight. Oh, this doesn't need to be dry. I don't know what I'm doing. See, I can't even keep up with the hoppers. Like they're constantly full now. That's why I said money's never an issue at the end. Once you get a high enough ranking and popularity. But you stop collecting money once your hoppers are full. But when you first start out, you're never gonna have that problem. You won't even have enough money to buy gum. You get pretty poor. I don't even really pay attention to this laundromat anymore because it makes me like $0. So once you get to a high enough status, literally this is going to be your focus. I already have plenty enough to get knocked down this wall and make a whole nother area, but I kind of don't want to because I'm trying to get upgrades. And I've been trying to complete a lot of these, as you can see in the arcade management, I'm trying to complete a lot of the goals. You can see everything has goals, and when you complete those goals, your their popularity mach the popularity on the machine becomes a lot more. Like we are at location bonus 99%, or 99, whatever I think that's percent. And that's also another way to tell how clean your place is. You want it at 25 is 25% is the max for cleanliness. So you obviously I missed something in the area to clean up. That's a big factor. You could change the difficulties on every single of the games once you get to past a little bit of the storyline. I think you have to get to the point where you unlock everything in the computer, or most of the things, I should say. So you're gonna have to have the Arcane Mania. Bought all these out. You're gonna have this. This is gonna be your most focused area right here. I'm trying to get this assistant so I don't have to do the hoppers anymore because it's annoying. You get to get a jukebox, and then you're also. See, I already have plenty enough to get this next room, but I'm not going to because I'm trying to get 600 bones. 600 EU dollars from eBuy. I have so much cash, it's ridiculous. The safe is always in the corner. Doesn't move. In order to, this is just where you have to put your money in here in order to buy anything online. That's the only way. And it'll store all the money. There's no penalty for keeping all the money on you other than you can't use it. There's accounts to show you how much you have, how much you know, EU cash you have on you. You see the total income of what you do every day. Yeah, you by clicking each one of these will change the graph. I'm at 85% or 85 popularity, which I believe that's customers or like how many customers would come in frequently, which gives you a lot of income, as you can see. See, the arcade is way more than laundromat once you get up there. Which, if you already passed the point of basic training, basically, which is literally the intro, literally, if you want to go and change every single one of these, which you're gonna want to, every single one of these games, and change it by first difficulty. That's how I do it. You want to change your difficulty, look at. You want plays per hour and per income. Hour increase per income. That's what you want. You want both of those. Because that's gonna. It's gonna increase your popularity of how many people play per hour. And then per hour is how much you're gonna make down the road. Especially with the price. So, like, if I have it on easy at 50 bones, literally I'm making like nothing. Because the more higher difficulty means the more they'll come to, as you can see down in the corner, they'll say how much the customer will play in a single credit before they get to a game over. And this will also tell you there's more information down at the bottom, location and fame and all that, but doesn't really tell you how to get this. So in order to get more popularity, to get more money, you want the gold bonus up there, fully complete. And some of the goals are pretty ridiculous and hard to get, but some are pretty easy, so. Which will increase fame bonus. Then you're also. It's hard to really tell where to put a machine for popularity. I wish there was a way to move the games once you place them, but there isn't that I know of. But I haven't got that far either. I'm literally, I would say, like mid game is where I'm at. I have so much money where it doesn't matter, but I also don't have enough EU bucks to even get all the upgrades, which is there's a couple upgrades that I want. There's a couple of upgrades that you shouldn't get, in my opinion, because making money is about everything. That's what I say. So obviously I want this game probably around medium to hard, and then increase the pay. You want to really look at that plays per hour and see you which one would be the best outcome. There's some that are exactly the same, that are literally identical. Like See, I'm getting 417 here. Plays per hour is more. Then have it on medium and a dollar. So obviously you'd want to have 50 and probably hard. Because then you're getting the plays per hour and you're getting income. That is my theory. But this also teaches you how to play. Like, blockchain is one of the hardest games, and I still don't understand it. There's a couple games that I played, like Zombat, or Combat, whatever you want to call it. This game, I cannot get the minigun for the life of me. I've played, I don't know how long. I even put on easy, because once you put the difficulty on, let's say, hard, it's hard for you in that game as well. So you're going to be playing on hard. I've even changed it to easy, and still, I can't do it. But there's some settings that I kind of want people to be aware of that would probably make them make it more easy for people, like laundry mode. I put it on toggle instead of hold, so you don't have to hold down the button, so you literally just click it when you're over the, let's say you're at a washing machine, and instead of it telling you to hold the button down, you literally just click it and automatically do it. So it makes speed running a lot of clothes a lot faster, because you can constantly press X when you try to get to another, like, here, I'll show you. Yeah. So, let's say, literally I'm not even holding it, I just press it, and it does it automatically for it. If I want to stop it, I just press X again. See? I'll stop. You just press X again. I mean, there's no reason to stop, but you can. And then I can constantly click X over any of these, and I'll do it faster. So it's kind of like speedrunning washing machines, really, be honest. Usually when these are full, I just go over here. Oh, I have a whole set over here. I didn't even notice. Once the day is ended and closing time comes, all dryers and washers will cease to be operational. You cannot interact with them anymore because it's closing time. Is there closing there? Maybe not. Oh, but you cannot interact with games, you can't interact with trash, none of the hoppers you can interact when it's 2300 is when closing time comes, which is about 5 hours for me, aka 5 minutes. But there's a little neat trick that I want people to be aware of as well. Once close to 2300 hours happens, you can pick a game that's literally any game that you feel like you want to play. And you play that for infinite time. There is no time limit on it. You will not be forced to pass out. Basically, time ceases to exist at 2 in the morning. It's kind of hard to explain, but I could show you once the time comes around. See, I already got a grand in one day. Like, it's not hard. It's hard to get S ranks because you gotta be really on the money in order to get an S rank. See, I got a B rank, star 1B. It's still good, but S ranks is like 30 bucks. I can't get S ranks anymore because I'm just too busy fixing all the machines or doing other stuff. That's why I say it's kind of useless. What are you looking at? It's kind of useless to really take care of the laundromat anymore. You're making so much money on the on the arcade, it's not even funny. Oh, this is the game that's pretty difficult as well. Very long. And then this is just little mini games to fix games. You're in the medium area. You can see the coding on the screen when it is broken, and you just fix it by pressing whatever your interactor button is. But let's say, for example, closing time is about to come in a couple of minutes. But you want to get on a machine before 2300 hours. Oh, look, here's the piece, last piece. Oh, I got a full bag too now. Go throw it away. See, I'll even show you. If you completely miss, you get no money. Or if you do, it's like, yeah, you get no money. Even though you get it in there, you get like nothing. That's the only one thing I hate about it. So, I'll do Zombat, which in my opinion is, I feel like a failed experiment. Like, they were gonna make a game called Combat, because you can see the C underneath the Z, and they just left the background a texture box, and I think they gave up and just said, you know what, we're just gonna change it to a Zombat, turn them into zombies instead of people. I think they got lazy on a couple things, because there's even a couple games. You'll even pause the game if you're in a game like this. This is a simple shooter game. You just pick a person and you literally kill zombies. That's literally it. I can go through all these, but like, see, I paused the whole entire game. Here. There, see? Literally, when you press options, it'll even pause the game inside the game. That's weird to say, but that's a thing. And I don't know if this actually works by changing it to easy while you're in the game. I don't know if that actually works. But this game is a pretty well. Kind of. You motherfucker. As I say. Yeah. I'm not playing that anymore. I think it's this game. Because you can see this racing simulator is burnt into this screen. Can you see it in the background? I don't understand why it looks like that when it shouldn't. Because that is literally this. If that makes sense. I feel like that's a mistake. But anyways, it's about almost 2300, which is about closing time, and then no washes will, I mean, you can continue taking them in and out until 2300, but they'll stop producing over here once that time comes. Always empty up the hopper. Hopper's back here for your laundromat. It'll constantly, even if you don't wash any clothes, you'll constantly get money. It's basically infinite. Those are really basic. I mean, there's nothing really much to do in here other than you're safe here. You got a nice random radio in here. If you ever need to listen to voicemails again, they're here on this answer machine. And you can go through any of them and just play them. See, yeah, it's just, that's literally all. Cool, lava lamps are cool. God, I hate this radio. I have no idea if the jukebox is copyrighted. I did buy a couple songs in there, but it's literally just music. You can get basically free money off of it. I put it at max, because that's where you get the most money. There's no reason not to. Let's see, what game should I show you constantly? How about Strike Gold? So, I mean, this is one of the games that you basically buy straight off the bat. Like, I think this is like, you can either buy this game or another game. Like, there's two games that you can buy. It's either this or the other, and you get to pick one or the other when you first start out. And usually people pick this one, because I think it's one of their popular ones. Surprising. And it's a pretty simple game. It's really, you get oxygen by going down. That's literally it. You can even jump up if you need to. Just don't get crushed, because you will die. I think it's four of a kind in order to get one. Yeah, no comps are good. I don't know how that's floating, but that was. Am I the only one that saw that? Yeah, it's four of a kind in order to get one. Each swing is oxygen as well. Lose oxygen each swing. Oh, I got crushed. Well, that sucks. Times it. Well, it's almost 2,300. So, once it's close to 2,300, get on any game that you want to play for infinite time. And then, do not get off that game, which is the whole triangle for me, is to exit the game. I don't know what it would be on for PC or any of the other games, but once you're on there and you exit off, you cannot get back on, like, at all. Like, you will not, like, if I exit off, I will not be able to interact with anything other than going home. So, just to bear in mind. But, yeah, this, once 2 a.m. comes, you don't pass out, you just stay there. Yep, that's it. You just can infinite play game. Or infinity. Which is kinda cool. I just did that on accident. But well, while I'm doing this, I should have did this in the beginning of the video. I don't know if anyone saw the previous time when I just first bought the game, and the first person to comment on the video was the developers, which was pretty cool. I was very confused. I was on my way to work, actually, when I saw that message. I doubt they'll ever watch another one of the videos, but I thought that was pretty cool. You guys should go check that out. It was a stream I did, technically. I kind of recorded it like a stream, if that makes sense, instead of streaming it. But see, it's already what is that, midnight? 0 hours, yeah. It starts over because it's a military type. But another thing you guys definitely want to keep an eye out is the to-do list when you get this activated, because this is the only way you can get Euro currency. The pounds, I think it is European currency. This is the way you can get by. The only way you can get upgrades, like actual upgrades. Yeah. But like, I can show you, once I get off this, I won't be able to interact with anything. Oh, wait. It's 2 in the morning that it does that, doesn't it? Can I? Oh, I can. It's 2 in the morning that it does. I thought it was 2,300 hours, my bad. Well, anyways, once 2 a.m. in the morning comes, don't get off the game. I promise you, you don't want to get off the game. Because you won't be able to interact with anything. But once you get off the game, the only thing that's going to force you to go home anyways. This game is pretty simplest, but it is really difficult. I found a little cheat spots in order to maximize my survivability, because, and the flamethrower sucks, by the way, don't get it. It looks cool, but it's not. It slows you down and it reloads forever. In the corner will tell me to, these little running ugly Teletubby looking guys. Uh-huh. I played this a lot and still cannot get the minigun for the life of me. I've been trying to get the minigun forever, which is 250. I've tried a million times and I still can't get it. I even cheated this game out as much as I could. See, it's 2 a.m. This is where you're supposed to pass out, but I don't. I can play this game for as long as I want. It's a good way of getting your abilities up, or your stuff done, whatever you want to call it. They get pretty ridiculous after a while. I like the shotgun the best. It does piercing damage, it goes through enemies, and it kills multiple in one shot. Goodbye. Grenades are pretty decent too. It is airstrikes. Suck at this game, like heavy. It's, I wish I could show you my score. I've played infinite amount of times and still can't beat it. I'll probably do video on each game eventually, and maybe I can show you like little hidey places or easy ways to complete it, but I haven't even played every single one of these games. A lot of these games are pretty hard to master the skill of. I wonder if anyone's already did videos on these, on how to beat a couple of these video games. So a lot of these arcade games are quite difficult. I've been trying to get the minigun forever. I die every time because these zombies don't stop coming. But yeah, that's mostly the basics of the game. Just focus on the laundromat when you first start. Then once you get to the middle of the game, I definitely go straight arcade then, because you'll be making quadruple of what you'd be making now. Try to get these goals on each of these. It'll increase the popularity once you get the goals. And you get money on it for it. Once you make so much money, you'll actually get achievements. That's why I like the shotgun. God damn, runners. Oh, 250. I'm not even halfway there yet. Come on, I'm almost there. No, you gotta be kidding me. This game. That's literally the only gun I don't have. I have every other gun. I can never get there. I collected 243. And that's why I quit this game. And then I can show you that. Getting off that game, you cannot click anything. Like games, nothing, can't even do the laundry. If there's still a time on the laundry, it'll completely end and just go to the end cycle. But, I mean, there's no reason not to put laundry into the washing machine because it's $5 each. Even if it's on C rank. C rank's the lowest you can get. There's no $0 for washers. But I mean, other than that, that's the basic tutorial. I mean, there's a quit and save if you want to end the day and you go to the main menu. That's what that is. Don't forget to definitely do these to-dos and definitely manage your arcade and go through the list. Other than that, you just go to the bus stop, leave for the day, and then it'll save there. And if you want to skip the bus ride, you just press or hold X, or whatever your interactive button is, and you'll skip the bus ride, if that makes sense. Other than that, if you want more tutorials, definitely let me know. I was thinking about doing a couple tutorials on some of the arcade games. And try to give you the best possible score and objectives done. Alrighty, guys. You guys have a great day. Kaluda, show out. Peace out, guys.